কি করলি তুই এটা? কে ব্যাক ক্যামেরা কি করে অন হয়ে গেল আবার?
Okay, I think this is sharp 7 o'clock in the evening, and the time has come to begin today's session. I request everyone to keep your audios on mute mode so that it will help us to, you know, it will be audible for everyone. If possible, keep your videos on. That will be really great. It will be a great motivation for the host as well as the speaker, so that we can connect with each other very well, because that is where we can have some face-to-face communication. On that note, let's begin. Very, very warm welcome to all of you on behalf of Protouch. I'm Dr. Aparna Sethi. I'm founder of Protouch, come with 20 years of experience. I'm a corporate trainer and work predominantly in the areas of diversity, inclusion, prevention of sexual harassment at workplace, emotional intelligence, and many more programs. I deliver a lot of customized programs, and I welcome you all. Without wasting a single minute, let's begin with the session. Before that, I would like to also introduce about Protouch. Protouch corporate training solutions. We are into training solutions. We deliver programs, customized corporate training programs, as well as we have certification programs like HR generalist, HR analysis, so that's a part of virtual sessions. So we are into coaching, and we are also associated with IIM Exhilarai Through Times Group and many more universities for executive training programs. We will be sharing information in the chat box with all of you to remain in touch with us and get more information about us. But it is not today about us. It is about something else. And what is something else is we all are witnessing the COVID-19 situation. The impact of COVID-19 on health, economics, and market is an unfolding story that is complex and fluid in its ever-changing dimension. One of the biggest impacts of the virus has been on the organization and the nature of workplace. During this transition, work from home became the immediate solutions for companies. And now many employees are also getting ready to come back, especially post-Diwali. There are many employees are already back. During this tough time, productivity, motivation of employees, and most important, employees' safety, technology adoption, and many more challenges came in front of HR. And believe me, HR have been in a constant mode of reinventing policies during this tough time. So hats off to all the HR professionals who are working day and night to motivate, engage, as well as have business alignments. Today we have with us Mr. Suresh Kumar, Executive President and CHRO at Polycab from Mumbai. He comes with more than 25 years of experience in HR. And I'm so proud to share with all of you, he has worked with some of the really best brands. And to mention few, it is JK Industries Limited, Hindustan Lever Limited, ACG Bond White, Mufatlal Industries Limited. And if you go through his LinkedIn profile, you will get to know the areas in which he's working. It is my honor and privilege to welcome you, sir, from your busy and really busy schedule. Thank you so much for giving us time to share your experience. Welcome you, sir. Can we give some reaction buttons and welcome Suresh, sir, please, everyone. Great. Thank you, Sudeshna, for that thumbs up. That makes a great, personal invite. Thank you so much. Thank you, Richa.
Thank you.
Great, sir. So today we have a lot of HR professionals and majorly young HR professionals are also there who are looking forward to make their career in HR. So just to tell all of you, today we want to have this session extremely interactive, okay? I will be asking, on my agenda, there are only two questions. After that, the forum will be open for all of you to ask questions. I will be picking up the relevant questions. Of course, there will be a lot of other questions. If the time permits, certainly I would love to take those questions. So can I expect questions from all of you? Let me know. Can I expect questions from all of you, right? So let's make it memorable. Let's make it memorable because every webinar, every session is always in hands of both the parties. One is the people who are delivering and others are participating. So I expect high level of energy and interaction from all of you. On that note, sir, the first question is, as many employees have started logging in remotely, what changes do you see in work from home to maintain the productivity high? Because we have seen when people are getting into work from home mode, most of the time the productivity is going down. The motivation is going down. So what do you think, like what are the policies you will get to see and what are the changes do you see when we have work from home, and which will impact the productivity?
See, in order to answer your question, let me be a little more frank in telling you that the work from home, what is happening today, that is because of certain conditions and circumstances. Otherwise, we have never experienced work from home previously. And at least in the Indian environment and conditions, this is altogether a new experience for the people. And as I have seen in many companies and as well in my present companies, I don't think that it is going to last so long. Once your pandemic situation gets over, we will go back to into our previous normal. There is no new normal as it is, because this condition has been imposed on us. These things have been imposed. Today, when I speak of work from home, what is that the people complain about it? They say that they are unable to interact personally. They feel that there is, the communication, networking, as far as the technology is concerned, has really grown up, but we as a human, we need to have some amount of personal interaction and personal networking. That is where the people are. Today, if suppose one of my colleagues is sitting at home and I'm giving her an advice, and if she need to drop me up and show, personally show me something that this is what she has done, something great, is not possible while we are working at home. Mm-hmm. Okay. And if you see the policy aspects are very dynamic. Be it work from home or not to be work from home, now it is so dynamic that every 6 months you need to review your policy.
True.
And so when we speak of the work from home and we speak of the productivity, of course, the productivity is something that has really become a cause of concern. The person who is working from home, he has got a feeling he's doing so much of hard work and which has not been encouraged by his bosses. If you go back to the bosses forum and you ask them, they say we are unable to measure the productivity because we don't know what this guy keep on cribbing that he has been working for so long, so much of hours in a day, and I don't know what he's doing over here. So there is a gap. So both the sides, if you look from the superior sides as well as from the employee side, and there is some amount of gap that is happening and the people are not very happy with the process that is there. Only change that has happened over here is the people have stopped cribbing about work-life balance. Because as far as the work-life balance is concerned, now they are with the family. Now, if you see the irony of that, it is something which I am experiencing and a lot of my colleagues are experiencing. We have literally converted our home into office.
Absolutely.
Okay. Absolutely. Now, what do you mean by a home? What do you mean by a family? You cannot have a formal relationship with them. You need to be very informal with them. But while I am having a webinar, I don't want my kids to come and sit beside me. To be very frankly telling, at the same time while I'm working from home, I want it to be purely disciplined. I wanted to get locked in one of the room. I don't want them to be interaction, but home is not made for that. Home is to be very, very liberal. Home has to be very open. So that is the changes which are taking place. And as an HR from the HR fraternity, as an HR head, the challenge is before me or before us is to see that. The challenge before us is to see that how we can really, really see that the employees, while they are working from home, and the superiors, what is their expectations, and they are convinced that whatever the deliverables they wanted from the employee is being solved, and how this is measured. We have taken some steps into it that I will share as we go along, but really it is a tough time.
You know, Suresh, if you look at it, it is very strange. Last week I delivered a session on stress management because when we are working from home and all, and then I asked employees and the participants that what is it that one thing now you will do after this session? What will be one action you will take? And to my surprise, 90% of them said, I will spend quality time with my family. So now it is the big question mark that are we really with our family? Are we really able to solve, you know, the challenges of work from home or what it is, right? Having said that, there are many, many companies have declared work from home now till June, July. You know, some companies have completely gone in, you know, work from home mode. But what is happening in manufacturing as far as work from home is concerned? If you can throw some light on that, that will be really nice.
See, manufacturing, if you see that we have opened our offices, our manufacturing are running.
Mm-hmm.
We have got somewhere 24 units under the Polycab umbrella. So all our factories are running. And as a result, the people are coming and attending the offices. So
okay.
so that we have almost opened somewhere in the month of August. Until then, we have been running in a very phased manner of almost 25 to 30% of the people coming to office. And it was more scattered like. So one batch will come on one day, second batch will come on second day. And as a result, whereas there has been a support functions, jobs like commercial, procurement, HR and all, and they have been managing from work from home. So this was a mix and match that was happening over here. Now, and that is how we differentiate from the manufacturing and other industries. To a greater extent, manufacturing, while the things are happening on the shop floor. While the things are happening at the shop floor and the things are moving on the ground, you cannot separate it from other places. So you need to be present on the ground. So that is how you differentiate manufacturing from the service industries or IT industries or other industries. But okay, let us again, the manufacturing again, you can divide it into two major elements, like one that is purely concentrating on the factories and manufacturing, and others who are driving the sales.
Absolutely.
And for instance, we have got a corporate office which is based out of Bombay, and we have got a branch office which is spread across the country. Still, those branch offices and the corporate office to an extent can manage working from home. Because for us, the presence in the factory or presence on the ground is not as much required.
Mm-hmm.
The only aspect what is that is happening today, even the sales force which is there, when you have been interacting closely, when you have been discussing with the people so closely, and when there was a lot of personal networking which used to happen and the people are missing it there. So people are experiencing a gap. They find it, okay, it is something of that you see a TV news.
Mm-hmm.
And while seeing a TV news, you are enjoying the news, but you are not able to relate yourself with the news. That the same thing is happening while we are going for this virtual webinars, the virtual conferences, virtual telegroup. It sometimes appears to be very artificial. They say that
one question here, you know, I have one question here. Like, there are few employees are ready to come back. Having said that, there are few employees are not ready to come back. The families have a constraint. They don't want to come back because, you know, another thing which we get to see is like when they're working from home, their expenses have come down. Because if they are coming to the bigger city, then their rent and all, everything they're paying, you know, the food charges, everything has gone down. So that is also another reason that people don't want to come back. But if they are saying, because of the safety reason, I don't want to come back to office. What are the stands you are taking in your company? What are the actions you are taking? And in case where the physical presence is required, without that, you cannot run the business.
See, I will answer your question in a very different manner. Now, in case if suppose one has to go to market and buy grocery and vegetable, so what is going to do? Because we understand there is a COVID and pandemic situation today. But whether he will not starve, he has to go to market and buy it. No, he has to be with the people. So that my safety lies with me. That what precaution I can take for me, that is the paramount importance. What is that I will be doing for me is the number one. I cannot be dependent on somebody for my safety. The corporate, the companies will definitely take certain course of action in order to see that the safety and health are given paramount importance. I'm not at all denying that. But what is that I am doing for me? What is that? Today, when you go to the market or when you roam around the places, it doesn't appear to be pandemic. This is Diwali season. The markets are fully crowded. The people are going and they are on their purchasing spear. Why? Why is it so? They are going and buying the things from there. And the one guy who complains about not coming to office for the safety reason, the same guy we can see in the crowd. So as a corporate, we as a responsible corporate, we have got certain duties. What is a corporate does when there is a pandemic? We don't want that entire crowd to be coming to office. No, we can definitely have the offices. We can divide between the work from home and offices. We can have the shift working, for instance. We can go for a shift working, or we can go for a scattered working. One group of people is called on one day, another group of people are called on another day, so that we maintain whatever precautions are required during this pandemic situation in terms of maintaining distancing. And over and above, there are temperature. We have got the technology has really moved up a lot. For instance, in case you suppose a guy who comes to my office, there is a scanning, which auto scanning happens, and its attendance is also stored. That auto scanning will be happening as far as his pulse rate is concerned, his temperature is concerned, and his attendance is also marked. So this is the number one precaution that is being taken. Number two precaution is that those all who are in the cabins, they are not allowed to move out of the cabins. They have to remain in the cabin. Number one, and whenever and there is a need of a social distancing, so we see that the people are not sitting among each other, and there is some amount of gap being prevalent, and that is how we scattered the job. Okay, but at no situation, I feel that none of the company should encourage people not coming to office.
Okay.
This is my personal take on it, because we want people to come on office, and secondly, the very important is that. That any policy or anything that is being driven by the company philosophy and values. As an employee cannot dictate the policy for his benefits. The employee cannot dictate policy for his privilege.
True.
Today, there are companies, in case if suppose you are working from home today, there are many companies I know, especially my company, we are not any salary cuts and all. We have not said that you are not coming to office. That's why we are cutting your conveyances and we are cutting your... That's the extra savings you are opening because of the circumstances that is prevailing today. Okay. So how you say that I am going to lose on my money? You cannot say that.
True. Very true.
Okay. So so this is my answer to your question.
Yeah. You know, one thing I just want to know, I'm very curious to know about this. Like when they are, employees are going on their own outside, maybe in the market and all, and if they get infected, then the, you know, the entire ownership is on them. But suppose if the employee is coming to the workplace and then he gets infected, he or she gets infected, then what will be the course of action? Because that is where the ownership, is it on employer's side? Is it on their side? And what will be the course of action employer needs to take in that case?
See, answering your question, let us understand if someone is getting affected. There are certain cases which has happened in our branch office too. So what is that we have done is whosoever who that guy has been interacting, and see, we take all precaution to see that they're not interacting much. There is they're maintaining the social distance. Even if suppose they get infected, we ask them to go to sit at home for 14, 15 days. And when you get cured, you come out. Touch wood. So far, though there have been some infection which has come to our notice, but nothing grave has happened to our in our case, and the people have recovered and come back. Okay.
How about insurance policies and all in that
insurance
case?
See, we have got an insurance policies. All our insurance, see, all our employees were otherwise also covered under the insurance from the very beginning. So our welfare policy is like that. So while they are covered in the insurance, when this pandemic started, so we had already discussed with the insurance company and extended for covering this COVID cases too. So to that extent, the employees are covered. We don't foresee. And over and above, what is that we have done in our company is that we have extended our welfare policy.
Could you please elaborate more on that?
I'm coming to you. See, when we speak of the welfare policy, we say that anybody at your family, anybody for whatsoever reason, you should not feel that you don't have the money. And as a result, you are unable to take the treatment. We don't want, none of our employees should be saying that. So the first and foremost thing we as a company, we intend to do is that we wanted to support them financially. Whosoever they are in the families, because ours is a widespread company, we have got employees on pan India basis. We have got the branch offices and all. So whenever there is a requirement of the money or whenever they feel that the company need to help out to them, we have never lagged on that. We said, okay, that is a fundamental requirement. Let us do it. The first and foremost, we never allow the employees to suffer because of lack of money. That was the first and fundamental philosophy which we have worked. So having done that, and how that need to be adjusted, that is subsequently we will decide whether it has to be converted into a loan or whether it has to be given as an ex gratia or whether that is all subsequent. But at that particular moment, nobody should say that I am suffering because of want of money. This is the first step we are taken as far as our welfare is concerned. Not even to the distant relatives, if they come and say that, okay, my relative is there, sir, he's suffering a lot, and as a result, we are facing a financial, please help us. So we make it sure that whosoever the local guy present in that particular region, he goes and he helps them financially, or at least gets them into the hospital and see they are treated well. How that registered, that we will decide. So to that extent, we have managed the welfare policy very well. Number two, what we are doing over here is that the communication channel. Our communication channel, if you ask me, is very, very elaborative and very comprehensive too. For instance, we run our own radio, to be very frankly telling. And this radio is something like an FM radio. Okay, so you can go back to the radio jockey, you can share your views with her, and you can get connected in the various aspects, and she will come back and respond to you.
Okay.
And this is entire family can listen. And there is a music into it, even the chairman message, it goes through the radio only. So we have these type of communication channel working with us, where we keep continuous engagement with employees and their families. This is number two. Number three, what we do over here is, we have already have certain guidelines and SOPs which we have made for the employees. So in case if suppose we say that these are the SOPs need to be strictly followed in case if you are coming to office. For instance, we always say that anybody in your home, for the first question we ask is, anybody in your home is suffering from fever? We don't touch upon the COVID first. Is anybody at your home is suffering from fever? Now, have you got it diagnosed? So he has to have certain amount of undertaking before coming to office. And once he undertakes that and he says, no, everyone at his home is safe. You won't believe that almost for 50% of our employees, we have even carried out antigen tests free of cost in order to see that they are secured and there is they are away from this COVID and all. And whosoever we have found the symptoms, they have been provided necessary medication and even taken to the hospitals and all. So these are the certain steps which you are taking. But having said that, even today, even again, I am going to propagate on one thing is that ultimately my safety lies with me. So I have to take care of me, because the companies which are doing they can only do a catalytic action.
Right.
They cannot be responsible for your health. Your health is in your hand. You have to keep yourself safe. You have to keep yourself healthy. And you have to see that what precaution you need to take. Whatever action the companies are taking, these are just a catalytic action and they cannot do anything beyond it.
Absolutely right. Absolutely. Suresh, I just would like to know, is there any particular policy you have changed during this time? You have come up with, you know, that has changed drastically. One policy, if you would like to mention.
If you ask me, this was an opportunity to change all the policies.
Okay.
Starting from hiring policies to the welfare policy to the separation policy and all the policies. Because I feel that while we were working from home, we had some extra time to see that how our policy should be running. What policy, what changes have. So this really was an opportunity for us. Now, while we have been changing these policies, one thing what is very, very important to see and which we have been trying is that what is the overall philosophy or value of my company? And once I understand that philosophy and value, then that is where I need to translate into the policies. Be it a hiring policy, be it a welfare policy, and be it a separation policy. Because even if you are separating somebody from the company, we have a feeling that he should be graciously leaving the organization. And whatever the reason, whether you are terminating or he is resigning or going, whatever it be, but he should go with some amount of feelings that, okay, this is a place where I can come back in future.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so that is where we say that while you have to have a policy, the policy should be driven from the top management philosophy and values. What is that you exactly want to do, and your policy should be revolving around it.
Hmm.
So this is how we exactly try to do over here, and we change all our policy. To be really frankly telling, all my HR policy during these 3 months I have changed, and we today have got all the new. Even we came up with a new work from home policy, and if you look into our work from home policy, it is very clear. We have mentioned over there what are the timing for working from home. And what are the, we are even to the extent of, we have created a rosters, online rosters for them, where their immediate superiors need to go and approve about their hourly work and their weekly work and all. And once that is signed off, then only their attendances are marked.
Okay.
Okay, so this is one way of measuring the productivity of our end. So this changes we have done over here.
Great. I think that's a great insight on that. Having said that, there is one question has come from Richa Mathur. How HR can help out to stress out employee contribution towards their work? So I think to great extent, you have already, through this, you have already explained. So I hope you get the answer for that. Okay, there is another question coming from Karan. Sir, could you please tell us some policies that you feel are undermined but have a huge positive impact on implementation in an organization?
See, if you ask me, the two policies which I always have been banking on for almost, one is on the welfare and another is on the career development.
Okay.
Okay. These are the two policies which bring in a lot of a lot of motivational factors, not only motivational factors, but it brings a lot of loyalty among the employees.
True.
Okay. So when I speak of welfare, my welfare is not towards the employee. My welfare policy is usually towards the employee's family.
Okay.
Okay. And when I speak of the career development, then it is towards the employee. Okay. So this is two things which I feel in case if suppose are laid down properly and are articulated in a manner that that employee sees that it is a place for them, it is a good place for them to work, definitely the organization can go a long way in order to retain and have good talent in an organization and the people stay with an organization for a long time.
Amazing. I think these are great inputs you have given, right? So there are certain questions are going, will come across around career management. I think career, I will take it. There is another question coming from Trishant. That is work from home is useful or not? Is work from home useful or not?
It depends upon the type of sector you are into. If you are into an IT sector, you are into a service industry, of course, work from home is useful. But if you are into manufacturing setup or you are into the pharma cycle setups and all, then work from home is temporarily useful, but you are going to go back to your original place when this pandemic disappears. Because the work from home is not going to work over here. Because the work from home today, whatever is happening as a work from home for the manufacturing unit and whatever said and done, this is my feeling which I'm sharing with you, is that that all this work from home have more or less circumstantial, because the circumstances has asked to have this work from home. Whereas a lot of IT industries in the previously also, the people never used to go to office and they used to work from home. So to that extent, they have just extended and expanded it to other form. But in the manufacturing, the work from home is not going to work.
I think the exactly way you said, there is a best practices versus best fit. There are a lot of best practices are there, but I think best these best practices have become best practices because they have been best fit. The kind of workforce you have, the kind of industry you are in, what is the time, whether what is the stage of the company, you know, what is the seriousness of employees? Because somewhere still, I think, you know, we still take it as work from home is like a holiday kinds, and you know, we get into that relaxation mode when we are at home. And even employees have realized that when you are in pajamas, you feel like relaxed, you know, so that happens. So I think that is very important to keep it in mind, your industry, your workforce, your industry, you know, all these things. And then only we can take up the call, which is required, right? Okay, I think someone is asking me the question on Galaxy A30. It will be nice if you can rename yourself. But okay, I'm talking to Galaxy now. So what type of companies are you targeted for recruitment? Or, you know, it is about the HR generalist course, which we are providing, which is a certification by, you know, SHRM and HRCI, which you get. Honestly speaking, right now, we are targeting the companies who will be able to give safe and secure jobs to our candidates. Okay. So right now it is very important because there is happening right now also that there are a few companies are hiring and asking people to go. They should have a proper finances. So that is very important for us. And right now, getting a job is important than the companies. Most of the time we have seen that, you know, when we ask the best and dream companies, we have only 5 to 10 companies in our mind, TCS, Infosys, KPMG. But in India, there are many companies. Maybe we are not aware of their names. So we are targeting those companies. So that is what I can tell you. There are many, many interviews are in process. So that is happening. So that is about us. Okay. Can we take this question, Suresh sir, because it is changed a little about career based, and Manvi is asking how to change from sales job to HR job after 1.5 years of experience in sales. This is maybe deviating from the topic, but yes, young HR professionals will have these kind of questions. If you have more questions on policy based, HR based, do ask. But Manvi, certainly I will take this question because this question is there in the minds of many people. So that is about the career shift.
See, in case if suppose there is nothing wrong in shifting the career at any period of stage, not necessary that, and any experience what you are having in one field is going to help you in another field. In case if you are in a sales, and while you are in a sales, I do feel that you keep on meeting people, you keep on meeting your clients, you keep on meeting your customers. And only change is what is happening over here is that when you enter into an HR, your orientation shifts from the external customers to the internal customers. Okay. So to that extent, your dynamics change. But I am a strong believer in case if suppose in your entire career span, if you have got an experience of at least 2 to 3 functions, that will always enrich your career. And that is always help you to be head of your peers, number one. And secondly, what has happened recently is that while I have been discussing a lot of institutes, they have been calling me for many of the lectures and all. So I have been discussing with them. See, the people become redundant when they do a particular job for a longer time. Now, in case if suppose there is a corporate policy or there is a willingness among the employees and the individual to keep on shifting their career, keep on shifting their field from one area to another, then what happened is they gain expertise in many areas. So the redundancy factor will be very low. So when the redundancy factor is very, the employability will be very high. So and a lot of corporate, for instance, in our organization too, whenever a management trainee joins in an organization, he's moved into many departments and many functions. So once we assess him that what is that he is good at, then only we allot him a department. So while we are going to various institutes and we are telling that that while we are hiring, so we don't allocate them to a job at the first, on the instant basis. Only we say that it is an operations job or it is a sales job. So whether it is going to be a B2B sales or it's going to be a B2B sales or is going to be an FMEG or it then is going to be cables or into wires and cables, it all depends upon how he is going to shape in this first year of training. Then only we allot, and it can even be an exports. So we don't know about it. So that is how we drive it. And while this 1 year is so important for the candidate, because we don't keep him in a one place for a longer time. There are projects into it. He has to move into the functions. He has to go. He has to work in HR. He has to work in finance. He has to work in procurement. He has to work in commercial operations. Everywhere he has to do some amount of projects. And the people feel very hard pressed during the 1 year. My God, they are not. The company is not giving any time, because just coming from the college. And as soon as you enter into a corporate and you feel very hard pressed from the day one, telling that, okay, this is how I need to, because that is how we train, because we say this is where your training is required and we are investing into it. So there is nothing wrong in shifting the career from sales to HR, and it is only going to add value. That's why I have given these instances to you.
Absolutely. As sir has mentioned rightly, sometimes, you know, yesterday also I was having the conversation with one of the professional on the same topic, and he mentioned very clearly that you can also take some hybrid roles. For example, if you are from sales and sales and you want to shift to HR, you may not get into directly HR, but you can get into the hybrid role where you can look after business development maybe for some time, and plus HR, you know, that is where you gain and that is where you get a one step. So we have to have the strategic way of, maybe there is a little dip in the salaries and then you go ahead. And, you know, honestly, Manvi, 1 year is nothing. 1 year is just nothing. So don't bother so much. You're very young and you will go ahead. Having said that, there are so many questions are coming about jobs and regarding our own courses. I think Trishant, Varda, I will take those questions post 8 o'clock. Okay, I will stay back with you. I will try to address those questions. My co-founder is also with me. There are trainers with me. And we will have those questions. Let's focus right now about HR policies. And thank you so much for showing interest. Okay, there is another question. I think Pooja is asking that how HR policies can be made keeping gender neutral approach. So if you can throw some light on this, that will be really nice. Thank you, Pooja, for that question.
See, as I said, and that any policy that particularly is dependent upon the philosophy and value of an organization. So in case if someone is so much bothered about the gender, then you should know that any organization, it is very patriarchal in nature, should not be joining that organization, very frankly telling. Because whatever said and done in terms of the equal opportunity and whatever being said in and to it, then you find that hardly anybody is there in the organization, a fair sex sitting in a leadership role in that organization. Nobody is there sitting over there. And you come and join, you know that you are going to get stagnated at a certain place, at a certain level for that reason. So you have to make a choice that which organization I am joining, where I am joining. Who all are there at the leadership? How many females are there in the leadership position over there? What is the specific, whether the career path or career development of the organization provides equal opportunity to the employees? And this can easily be known. It is not nothing. In case, having said that, because there are many organizations we propagated that, but literally don't follow it. So preaching is different and practicing is different. So one has to be little more, for instance, there are many, and Livers, for instance, where I have been working. Rivers provides sabbatical leave to the woman employees, even for their studies, higher studies, during their marriages, during their maternity leaves. So that is something a very different company. And if you, my company, for instance, we don't provide any sabbatical leave for marriages and further studies, but of course we provide sabbatical leave for the maternity leaves and all. You have taken or even to the extent of 1 year we have provided. You go take care of your family and no salary cuts during this time. Eh? You come back and join us. So these are the certain things which you will be evaluating before joining a company, that how they are a more woman savvy company, and what is that they are doing it so that there is not much discrimination between the genders.
Absolutely.
So you need to do that study before choosing the companies. Then you take a call whether that company fits into your.
Great. So true. I think you have given a lot of practical aspects that changing everything will be very tough in the company. So it's very important to check how the culture is. And we get to know that if the culture is closed, the many, especially the new age applicants don't want to join that company. And so the companies are also changing and taking right steps towards inclusive culture than, you know, gender-based culture. So thank you for that answer. And, you know, we also provide a certification program in HR analytics research. And we have got really great candidates who are very experienced and they are taking the sessions from us. And there is a Harshit Sharma in the chat, you know, we have out today with us. And Harshit is asking how data analytics will help, you know, in future, especially if it is a strategic HR level. Do you think analytics will play a major role now?
See, you can know that analytics.
Just a minute, sir. There is some noise. Just a minute. Yeah.
See, the time is such that you cannot ignore analytics. Any major decision that is happening in companies today is based on the data, on the past data and the present data. And that is where your decision for the future is going to be. And for that reason, the HR analytics also has got a high strategic role to play in terms of the business decisions. For instance, I'll just give you some examples of it. For instance, in case if suppose we wanted to hire some sales, junior level salespeople, and we have got a data and we found out that the certain provinces in India from where we are hiring the people don't stick to us for a longer time. Whereas there are provinces where the people stick to us for a very long time. So what we do is that we do a calculative decision in saying that we hire from the places where the people stay with us for a longer time. So this is just an example where the analytics plays a role in hiring. Same is the case in terms of the compensation and benefits. And we take a lot of data from the what is happening, what the competition is doing today. Then we have an internal data is also that where is do our employees stand? Because whether what is there, how much is the individual difference, and the marginal differences taking place in an organization. All these decisions we can take only if we have the data in place.
Absolutely.
So for that reason, analytics has got a role, and analytics is a field which has got a lot of perspective in future. And I feel that any function for that reason, be it HR, be it procurement, or be it the business, they cannot do without analytics.
Absolutely. I think in HR, most of the time, hiring also used to happen on gut feeling, you know, and most of the time, wrong hiring used to take place. And when we have analytics-based, you know, analysis-based hiring, or for example, psychometric-based hiring, so, you know, at least the data is supporting to our decision. Okay, so gut feeling is perfectly all right. But having said that, if you get supporting data, then why not? So that the conviction is very high. And nowadays, people do not want to go on person-based decision, but data-driven. So because the risk is very, very, very high here, right? So that is what is about data and HR analytics. We have Poonam, and she is asking a wonderful question. Prior to current situation, commute to work in big cities was 1 to 2 hours. Now that has been replaced by family time or work time. Would you would like to hear your thoughts on how do we manage this transition? I think sometimes the work deadlines are not there now, right? So, because when you are at home, you have to pick up the call. When you are at home, you have to work. ऊपर से एक है ना वो एहसान हो गया कि लाइक फॉर एग्जांपल यू आर वर्किंग फ्रॉम होम जॉब भी है हमारी सेफ सो नाउ वी हैव टू वर्क सो हाउ डू वी मैनेज दैट
सी लेट अस सी बिफोर दिस पेंडेमिक व्हाइल फॉर इंस्टेंस आई ट्रैवल ऑलमोस्ट 1.5 hours फ्रॉम माय होम टू ऑफिस बिकॉज इन बॉम्बे द डिस्टेंस इज एंड द ट्रैफिक एंड द डिस्टेंस बोथ मैटर्स ओवर हियर एंड इट इज अ चॉइस बिफोर मी. If I have selected a city like Bombay, where I know that the traveling is going to be for 1.5 hours, and this I have been doing for last 10 years. Okay, right. This I have been doing for last 10 years, be it this company or by my previous companies and all. all of a sudden, because a pandemic has come, I cannot come with an excuse and say that the traveling is an issue for me. Okay, because this is why this pandemic has happened, this COVID has come, which was not there for over a century. So we have been managing in a certain way, and we have following certain pattern of life for all these years together. And just for these 3-4 months, what has happened, we felt that everything is going to get changed. That is not going to happen.
True.
Okay. My career, my choice of industries, my place of living is all dependent on me. The company never forces and asks you to join us. No, it is my own decision where I need to join, which place I need to go, which place I need to leave. So to that extent, in case if suppose some hardships, if that is there and that is a part and parcel of the life, I have to go with that, because everything I have selected, nobody has forced me to select that. So when I have selected all these aspects of the life, how I can blame it to others?
Absolutely. Wonderful. And even at the time of joining, we ask this question. See, it is going to take 2 hours. Are you fine with it? And they said that time perfectly all right. And after 1 month, these all issues start cropping up. So that is the biggest problem nowadays. Excellent. So thank you for that. And Poonam, I would like to add one more thing in there, that many companies are also following now silent hour. Now, what do we mean by silent hour? So in that silent slot, maybe that can be 2 to 3, 1 to 2, or any other hour. During that time, you cannot have any calls. You cannot make any calls to each other. You cannot schedule any meetings in that. I think that is very, very, very important. Okay. So that is the time. It's a silent hour for everyone. So many companies have taken that initiative. Another thing is, Poonam, I think, you know, it is also very important. How are you managing? Like, you remember when we were at office, you know, we used to call each other. Have you left from the office? Did you have your lunch? And we used to keep some time for our family. Now we ourselves are taking our family for granted. So if you are blocking the calendar, block a calendar for your family as well. That is the commitment you need to show, right? And enjoy the way, you know, you like, for example, my son is taking session from other room. My husband is delivering sessions from other room. I'm in other room. Honestly, we are just together, right? But then I know, like, today after this webinar, we are going to have a rocking time. But that you need to schedule. And that is our ownership than company. That is what I feel. So, you know, I can see a lot of smile coming from people. Trishan, thank you so much. That smiling face is encouraging. Keep smiling. Okay. So a wonderful question Trishant has asked here. Do we see any kind of change in HR role post-COVID?
If you ask me, HR role is changing daily, whether it is a COVID or a non-COVID. Today, and in my last almost 28 years of career, when I joined the company, I have never expected that the one day HR will be there in the board of the companies. Today, we are sitting in the board, and we are really advising and directing the business that what has to be done. So to that extent, the roles have changed, and it is becoming a very dynamic area, very, very dynamic, because now the business cannot run without HR. HR is no more. HR is given as much as important as it is, as to the finance department or any other department, which was not there almost a decade ago. Today, if you a lot of time, money is spent while hiring the HR professionals in the organization. And though there may be some amount of thinking that, okay, you can still have some amount of substandard people in other function, but not in HR. HR, they wanted to see that they are hiring the best in class, the best in people, because today the people management is the core for any business. And secondly, not only the people management, when we speak of the HR aspects, even the HR functions, if you look into the HR functions today, HR is primarily getting into the strategic role. It is no more the people. So when you are into the strategic role, the first and foremost thing, for instance, if you are starting a new business vertical, the first thing is being asked with the HR, the first thing is to be asked to the HR professional, okay, we are starting this business vertical, please let us know that what hurdles we are going to face. Number one. Okay, if the business verticals comes with some of the setting of the some of the projects in some of the places in country or abroad, okay, which are the right place to do that? So who has to answer these questions? These answers can come only from HR. About environment, about the conditions, about the changes, all these answers. So it has become a very, very strategic role. And it's becoming so strategic that in case if suppose one small decisions in terms of the capability of HR professionals can make the entire, can sink the entire organization. So to that extent, it is strategic now. I feel that the roles are very, it is changing. And today also it is changing. In case if I have taken a decision for one unit today sitting over here, that decision is not going to work for another unit. I need to see, I need to evaluate that what is that is happening in another unit and what type of decision I need to go over there so that the people are motivated and they keep on changing and they keep on working. So one place, one location, one HR decision does not work in another places. Though you may have a uniform policies and your policies also have to be more flexible in order to take care of your people.
Absolutely. Absolutely. I think during COVID, people have realized very important, those all stand-up comedian and all these people have realized the importance of HR, because the first thing started with employee safety, employee engagement, salaries, hiring. You know, business took a little, secondary role for some time. Of course, it is always a priority, but that is where employees came first. I think that is very important. And we realize that what is the role we are playing, motivating employees, motivating families. You know, when I was conducting corporate session, I used to all ask, even let your family members also join. It is okay, you know. Some people are saying, I said that that's the best thing which you can have, that families also sitting, especially work-life balance and all these sessions which I conducted. I see, because family plays a major role when you are want to have a balance, right? Like, for example, you are conducting the session and other things are going on. Earlier, maybe it was accepted, but now it has become little etiquettes which we all need to follow.
I wanted to add something. For instance, What has happened is there was a lot of dullness in our office after this COVID, because the people were scared of meeting each other. They have been maintaining the distances. So we in Bombay, there is a lot of festival which keep on happening during Ganesha and all. So one day we just thought that why we should not eliminate our office on all the 7 days of Ganesha. Let us eliminate and let us celebrate, maintaining the social distancing. Let some amount of positive vibe come over there. Let us create some amount of hangama. And let us have this live telecasted all across our unit on pan-India basis.
Amazing.
And let them also get the feel of it and let them sitting over there, let them join us in our celebration. We did this for Ganesha. Now we are going to do it for Diwali. And that has brought a lot of positivity among the people. They said, no, we cannot keep ourselves isolated. We cannot be a solo prayer. We need to be united. We have to have synergy among ourselves. And the best way is that we have to create occasion and Absolutely. We have to remain happy. And those equation can be anything. And let us create this. Let us build an occasion. Let us create it. And let us celebrate whichever way we can. Get the families into why we are having a live telecast over there. And the families are also joining over there.
Absolutely. I think this happy employees played a major role. I still remember in one of our meetings, you know, the struggle is still on and all everything. But one of our meetings, one of my team members said, you know, hey guys, we need to be really thankful that we have jobs. Our salary cuts have not taken place. And I think ours is the company. There are very 20% companies are still working from home and our company is still working from home. We should be thankful. I think if someone says that, you know, gives a lot of positivity around and so that these happy employees bring a lot of happiness. So that's a great thing to happen. Excellent. And there is a one last question. I think that is a very, very happy question I must ask you. That what was your happiest moment in this COVID time at workplace? What was the maybe emotional, happy moment which you experienced during this COVID time?
See, as I have been saying, as an HR professional, I will be more happy in case if suppose I find that I have done a bit in terms of contributing towards my employees. So the welfare policy, which I had said, where we have created a vibe in the employee telling that we are here to take care of yourself. Forget, be it the work, be it anything. And it is applicable for everybody in an organization, starting from the top guy to the lowest level of organization. And they say that whenever you have a difficulty, approach us. We will see that what best we can do it in our room. Money is concerned, forget about. See, when it comes to the need, the first aspect comes up with money. Money becomes plays an important role. If suppose we as a company, we provide that security and guarantee, we are besides you, don't have to worry about money. We will see that how that need to be adjusted in future. But today, whenever you require it, we are there. Don't shy away from us in asking. That has created a vibe, and I feel that we have worked too much in this area. Number two, what we have done over here is that people, there have been times, there have been some tough time for us. Because at this working from home going on, we have to close a few of our offices in India and other places and all. But one thing we have done over here is that while we have been strict and while we have been removing some people, one thing that first thing we have thought is that family should not be suffering. Right. So we have not terminated anybody. We have given them ample time to search for a new job. When they search a job, they come back to us and they say, sir, we have got it. Please resign and collect your dues on the same day. Number three is that in spite of it, because of the performance, because every time there, every year we have been, there have been some performance issue with the people. So we have been asking them to search for a job whenever it's going to be appraised. Even for the performance issues which have been coming over here, and we find that we need not enter, to that extent, we have been compensating them additionally. Maybe a 9 months salary or a 6 months salary or whatever. So that we feel that that's family concern for us was a paramount importance. That whosoever is working for us is always to take pride that, okay, this is the company in my bad days too, when I was not required by them. But until at that moment of time also, they have been taken care. So these are some of the factors which gives a really good, that brings a good, a feel-good factor to us. And we say, okay, we are really cultivating and we are building a culture where the employees feel pride in working with us, and really it is becoming more a performance-oriented organization.
Absolutely. Amazing. Having said that, you know, there is another angle to this, that you're a big company. You can survive by doing this. You have funds. But market... all the companies are not that big. Like we came across Asian Paints, you know, increasing salaries. Then I think there was one more, they were giving leaves to people, uncapped leaves to people. So these are the new things are happening. Indigo is saying, whenever we will hire people, the people we have asked them to leave will be the first people we will take them back. You know, so people are getting really human in this time. Having said that, there are still many challenges remains with startups or the mid-scale companies. So I think let's not take it to the heart. It is all about money, and yes, that's the hard truth.
I just wanted to, before I conclude, I just wanted to see one question which was asked by me, asked from a one IIFT candidate while I was giving a webinar question. So what about the jobs, whether we are going to get a job, and how the market is going to shape after this COVID. So what I have been telling them, that you don't worry too much about job. First and foremost, what you will be doing today is that how you can update your skill, how you can upgrade yourself, how you can make it more employable is more important. Why can't you be the people who are going to be who are going to be the job givers rather than the job seekers? Why don't you think in an angle? Why don't, and one instance came while we are just discussing it. Manika, how many of you have gone to the rural areas, discussed with the serpents and asked them, okay, how we can improve your own agriculture? You all are from IIFT candidates. You can help them in understanding more about the financial aspect to it. Build that relationship, build that networking, upgrade your skill so that you become unemployable. don't worry. These see opportunities are going to come in this country. It is just a very temporary phase. Startups are going to come. There are going to be an opportunity, but opportunity is only going to be to those people who have already upgraded their skills during this hour.
Absolutely.
and who are going to be better off than their peers.
Absolutely. Absolutely. You know, and I, you know, thank you so much for saying that, because we live in the area of social media. And, you know, on social media, negative news goes viral first than the positive one. So, you know, if you look at LinkedIn is full of rejection, 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 no certification matters and all. Please figure out what you want to do. Get away from this noise. I came across one person who was like, you know, what is it that you did during lockdown time? I was having food and sleeping. Please tell me, would you like to invest in this person? Even though the honesty is there, I mean, you know, if you're doing certain things, certainly it shows your learnability. Certainly it shows that how serious are you about your career, you know, and upgrading yourself. So that is very, very important for all of us to upgrade, upskill. And if you look at the learning curve, how it is going to be, your MBA degree, your graduation degree can give you a career of 2 to 3 years, not beyond that. You will face stagnation. Again, you need to invest, go for 5 years, you know, do that career. Again, reinvest. I mean, you know, reinvesting is the going to be a part of us. And at the age of, you know, 40, 45 also, we are investing and learning. That's the only way we can survive. I think there is one very nice question Trishant has asked. Is there any other jobs? I will say COVID has taught us one thing. Let's not depend on one job. A job you may have to leave anytime. So you have to have a parallel career. You have to figure out what you want to do. It can be training. It can be content writing. It can be hiring. It can be, you know, there are so many things you can think about as far as HR is concerned. So, and if you're thinking, don't think from the finance perspective immediately. These things will not give you immediate earning, but this will help you to explore new careers and keep yourself ready for the other role. So that even though my job goes, I have certain things. Look for the passive income. Look for the, you know, skills. And for that, don't ask money from other people. Give your samples and, you know, that will give you, because you are also sampling, you are also learning, why people should pay you for learning. And that is how keep your back or backup plan ready. Bahut baar log bolte hain ki backup plan hoga to 100% is plan mein kaise denge? Wo bolte hain. Calculative risk lena bahut zaruri hai. That's what I will say. Right?
Yeah, I can see what you have said. No, I just wanted to see, I'm 50. Today I'm almost touching 50 now, but I'm doing my PhD and it is almost at the flag at end of completion. Why I'm doing my PhD? But there's two reasons for it. First is that whatever experiences I have gained in my corporate life, and I need to see that how it is going to help me in the research and what better thing can happen over here. Second is that I have got a feeling I should not get retired in my life. So the corporate life has got a retirement age, maybe up to age of 60 and all. After that, once I have got a research degree with an experience that time of 40, 45 years, and if I get into an academic field with experience and my degree, I am still employable after that.
Absolutely. Absolutely. And this is what we need. Please understand, do not creep. Once upon a time, joining corporate was your career dream. And now you are abusing 9-to-5 life. We are living this kind of lifestyle we are because of that job. Respect. Let's not creep, because see, you know the power of energy. Whatever you creep about, it will go away from you. You know, so stay away from noise. Focus on the career aspect. It will take you ahead. And over a period of time, maybe 10 years, 15 years down the line, you will be on your own. Because 17 years CEO is only one or two in India or in the world. Not all. All college dropouts are not like, you know, like Apple CEO or someone. There are only 5-6 millions have got jobs and great careers because of education. Do not degrade that. It's all noise. Stay away from noise. I think that is what I will tell you, right? And before we conclude, I have something to say because I think my team has shared all the details with all of you regarding our courses, our website. Stay in touch with me. I have also shared my website link. I'm sharing one WhatsApp link group link, which is only for this particular group, those who are attending it right now. If you are a student of ProTouch, avoid joining that group, but I cannot compel you. So if you want to join, join, no problem. That is where we would, and if there is a conflict of interest, like we are a training organization, and if others is also a training organization, let's have our ethics in place. So let's not have the, let's avoid the conflict of interest. That is what I will say. Others can feel free to join this particular WhatsApp group so that we can stay connected, and it will help us to take this particular relationship and knowledge sharing sessions ahead in our life. That's what I will say. Those who want to stay back for any kind of career counseling or want to have more details about our course, do stay back. I would love to address your queries. So that's what I will say. On that note, Suresh sir, how should I thank you? I mean, thank you so much. And you know, you are so very enthusiastic that you want to add so much to our knowledge. I mean, there are very less people who are so eager to share experience and knowledge. I don't know about participants, but I have learned a lot from you, right from what kind of policies you are having, how to manage the career, and how to keep rocking at the age of 50 as well. Do you all agree with me? All
yes.
The participants? Yes? Great.
So Aparna, on this note, I am always available.
Yes.
Because in case if suppose, as I have been telling, not only on a policies aspect in any of the, because today I am heading both the strategy and HR with the company. So at any given time, if you feel that you need, again, you want me to come back for such sessions, I am open for it.
Yeah.
And only constraint what I have today is with the timings.
I understand.
So your timing has to match with my timing. That's the only thing which I can say. And with that, and secondly, not only your learning, even I have learned a lot out of the session because the type of questions that has been asked by you and by your other participants over here, those questions have been very encouraging. And it is not that we have got some ready-made answers. We have to deliberate something and have to take back something from our historical experience and all to answer those. So to that extent, even I wanted to thank you and all the participants.
Thank you. Thank you so much, everyone. So, sir, if you want, you can take a leave. Yeah, others who want to stay back with us so that I can share some, you know, updated information about the courses and all. Thanks a ton.
Thanks a lot.
Thank you so much. Thank you. Okay, so...